Well, welcome back outside, everybody. Me and my son are getting ready to head up this creek. Just in the little two-man bass boat. See if we can get on some redfish, speckled trout, maybe even a bass or two. Battery went dead right before we got on that. Awesome, got on a nice red. 16 inches. 17 inches.
I'm not getting trout on
that. It's on.
Get it on the drop. That's not good doing.
Up again on a red. Gosh, it took us all day to find a few. We finally got into a few later in the evening. Sweet, you need the net? Got them. Yeah, I saw someone with it. Yep, another nice little redfish for the day. We'll take it. Yeah, whatever it is down there, we can't fish it, so much gunk it keeps busting down there. You want to try that grassy bank again? We just want to keep going down this way. Might get lucky and pull another one off of there. Huh? You can't. There it is. There'll be a day where it'll be work, though. I think they'll work good for bass. Well, there, a lot of people use them for bass. Look at him go. Yeah, that's a setup to have right there. Oh, dude, I just got wrecked right there. I didn't hook him that time. Right in that same spot where I get hit before and missed him. Missed them. Check your hook point on those too. I did sharpen mine before because it was dull.
Yesterday I took my hook sharpener and my scissors, set them on my iron a bit, and now I come back to hook sharpener and got it with the scissors. So.
Is it digging your nail easy?
Yeah.
Okay, you should be good then. All right. I went home last night and I was looking up chatterbait stuff online they're fishing with. So I come across this guy and he's decently known on YouTube for guys. There he is. You know, I've been recording the whole time, so. We're hooked up. So I had some technical difficulties with batteries earlier. So two redfish and a bass into this. Austin just hooked his first redfish. Dude, is it a gar? Dude, I hope it's a red. So Austin's on to something good here. Dude, I don't think that's a gar.
Don't trick me. Be a nice red.
Be a nice red, please. Don't be a long-nosed... It's a red.
It's a red, right? I'll pull your teeth.
It's all right. It's just a red, right? We found some. All right, man. Fist bump it. Found some redfish. Sweet.
God,
so I'm gonna show you the stringer. I got a nice red keeper bass on here. Austin just caught one, but he probably ain't gonna measure.
Nope.
But it's still fun to catch.
What, 17, 15 and a half?
Yeah. It's worth it. Took us all stinking day. Been fishing since 7:30 this morning.
I just gonna sit there again. He ate it up.
Yep. We finally found a spot where there's some redfish biting. So sometimes you just gotta grind it out. Right? Grind it out and hope you can get some. Austin is hooked up again, y'all.
There we go.
Hooked up again. Had to grind it out. We got something going on now. Just want to put them in the net still, so we don't lose them. Sweet. Just like that, 30 minutes, got four reds, so. This is how your luck can change. All right, I'll keep recording. I'm gonna throw up in there. See if we can get another red to hit right here. You just slow reeling. What'd you drop? Oh, you're gonna get a picture and stuff?
Yeah, but
you know, a bunch of loud noise. Oh, you're all right. Oh, either ran. Oh no way, that's a hit. He hit it twice, right there. I missed them both.
Got him that time.
Came back for it a third time. He came back. Oh, I just lost him. Oh God. He came back for it. Dude, that was a good one too. He was peeling my drag. Dude, he came back for it a third time and I lost him. Oh.
I knew there was another one in there.
No way. Oh. Recording the whole time, too. The hit, the strike, the third hit.
They're on the 4 feet right here.
Huh?
They're on the 4 feet right here.
They're just in the warm part of the day moving up into that shallow flat. They're rolling up on a spot where. We've seen a few reds feeding right over here. Oh yeah, now that my camera comes undone. You know how it is, one of those days, you know. Yeah, we're back together now. You ready? We'll both cast at the same time. Let's see who gets it. I'll throw it by the tree, you throw it to the left. Oh, my line's across here. See, oh yeah, this is working out great. These ones don't want to eat our baits, I guess. Oh, yeah, see? Might not work right there. Yep, that's true. Guess you gotta reel it as soon as it hits the water. The thing is, that junk is right on the surface, too.
There he is.
I just started reeling it just under the surface. I think I got him hooked, Austin.
Yeah.
Sweet. Watched him hit it. Knew there was one over here feeding. Yeah, I don't think he'll keep. I don't know. He's respectable. He's the upper puppy size, you know. Catch you one over there. Well, redfish number three. Austin's at two, so we got five reds here in a short span. Found some feeding along this grassy bank. But the water's still, water's been pulling out all day. Tide's been running out all day. Oh. How many reds now?
That's three.
That's three. Nice, man.
How many?
You got three, you got three, so six. Just hooked up right off that point of that log right there. Wasn't expecting it. I was like, wait, did I just get hit? Set the hook and there he was. This old Field and Stream rod just kind of just wears them out pretty quick. Medium heavy, 7'2". It's good for reds though. Buries a hook into them. Yep, well, that's just number 7. Turns a slow day into a halfway entertaining day. Try to go incognito from these other boaters. Maybe not a giant, but it's a red. Alright. Well, let's just see you go. See you, buddy.